Still for a while, we will feel tensely because we cannot move. So our brain didn't get sensory information, you know. So I think it's a good time for relax yourself a bit before we get the slide. Oh, we got it. How about we stand up, please? So enjoy yourself, move. Move around a little bit, yeah. You'll feel better, yeah. Okay, you can do anything with your hand. Normally I'm in the office many days, but some days I will be in the field with the elephant. So it feels very good. Today I come from the elephant's campsite also. Yeah. Thank you very much. Have you ever touched the elephant before?
I did.
You did? How do you feel about the skin of the elephant?
All the children love the elephants.
Yeah. You one of them. Good.
And I followed the elephant beast which was here in Thai, I think 2 weeks ago. It was wonderful watching the habits of the festival of the 100 or something about the elephant.
Wow. That's a good opportunity, you know. A lot of Thai people still have less opportunity to be close to the elephant. Elephant is so smart and clever, but a small number of Thai people can be close with the elephant. You know, because, you know why? Because most of us stay in the city. And elephant normally not stay in the city, you know. So I also believe in the energy. I believe in the energy of the environment as well. So when I go outside to see the elephant, the environment is much, much better in your office, in my office, you know. So now today I would like to introduce Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program. For children with special needs, I have been work in this program for 12 years. This year is the 12 years for us. Actually, we have our team to work on the elephant and with the children with special needs. One I would like to say about is Dr. Nuntanee Satiansukpong, Darani Sasat. Yeah, we come from Department of Occupational Therapy, Faculty of Associated Medical Sciences, Chiang Mai University. Okay. Children with special needs are those who need some support in their daily life, either in doing self-care, play, or academic activities. And some of them also have less opportunity, especially limited in social interaction. Because when children with special needs, they would like to play with the other children, they have difficult time. They don't know how to approach their friend. They don't know how to play well with their friend. So many children, many typical children don't want to play with them. Okay, so this program is provide the opportunity for children with special need to play. You know, in the program we have the play, the game for them to play, so they have the opportunity to play with the other children as well. The objective of this presentation today is to introduce the alternative treatment program for children with special needs, namely the Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program. We call it TETP. If you would like to see more detail, you can go to our website, www.tetp.org. Okay. And the reason of using elephant as a therapeutic medium, and some previous research findings were provided. Some activities in the Thai elephant assisted therapy program, such as buying elephant food, feeding the elephant, bathing the elephant, playing a game with the elephant, were presented, and also their benefit were explained. Animal assisted therapy, AAT, different from the animal assisted activity, AAA. Do you know how different? AAA is just use the animal to be in the surrounding of the patient without the therapeutic purpose. But for AAT, it's for therapeutic purpose. Okay. So animal is used as a medium of interaction with a therapeutic purpose. So AAA, also known as pet therapy, is the introduction of an animal into the intermediate surrounding of an individual. Previous studies of animal assisted therapy reveal physiological and psychological benefit. For example, calming influence, decreased heart rate and blood pressure, reduced fear and anxiety, increased strength and improved cognition and balance. And so many reasons that why we use elephant as a therapeutic medium. One of them is that the activity with the Thai elephant fit with the model of practice in occupational therapy. The last sight of the elephant may attract the interest of the child and motivate him or her to interact with elephant and the environment. As you know, children with autism, they're not interested in their surrounding. They not even know when you come close to them. They not notice you, or they don't know what's going on in their environment. You know. So the elephant characteristic, they move back and forth, even by sit still. I'm sorry, by stand still, they move back and forth, and also they. Waving their ears all the time because of the insect and also the heat. So this characteristic of the elephant is good to intrigue or impress children with autism. An elephant eats a large amount of food, 200 kilograms per day. This provides a child with special needs more opportunity to interact with and care for the elephant. Normally, children with special needs, they don't have the opportunity to care the other person. Normally, they just accept care from the other. So this is a very good opportunity to learn how to care for the elephant and also how to care for their parent when they come with their parent in the elephant camp. Riding and bathing elephant are also relevant activities in the model of sensory integration because they provide tactile, proprioceptive, and vestibular. One thing that children with autism have is normally they have some of them have sensory processing disorder, so it's good to provide them with touch and the perception from their muscle and tendon, okay, and also the sensory stimuli that stimulate their vestibular system. Thai elephants are clever and caring animal. You know why someone get on the elephant? Some, like if I get on the elephant, I sit on the neck of the elephant, and the elephant will use his ear or her ears, you know, cover my leg, you know. So, and elephants also very gentle, and the speed of walk is similar to human walk. Why the children with special needs walk along with the elephant, they don't have to run, they just walk slowly, just regular speed. So it's good to use elephant. And this morning I was in the camp. We got the two new elephants to be in the treatment program. One thing I would say that not every elephant can be used as a therapeutic medium, just only some of them, okay? And this morning we got another two new elephants to be in the program. And I would like to say that they are easily trained to assist in treatment program. This new elephant, the Mahout, have trained them before coming this morning to grab the ball with the trunk, with its trunk, and then throw the ball to the children. Okay, today I'm going to talk about the previous study a bit. Okay. Study. We start to do the first study in 2007 because at the time the elephant expert would like us to explore the elephant use benefit for children with special needs. And at that time, it also have another issue with the elephant, for example, some elephant has been used in the wrong way. For example, use the elephant in the city to beg for the food. Okay, so it's not a good situation for the elephant. But why I work as an occupational therapist, I would like children with special needs gain more ability. So then we think that, okay, we try to use the elephant therapy with children with autism, the first group. And later on, I did another research to work with the children with Down syndrome, okay, and we published in the Occupational Therapy International. Okay, during this period, I try to do another study because we got the doctorate student from the U.S. to stay with me for 4 months. Two of them will help me to do new program. So today we try to implement the new program for children with ADHD, Attention Deficit Hyperactive Disorder. Okay, come back. I talk about the first study. This is the first time in the world that we use an elephant as a therapeutic medium. It's a collaboration between Department of Occupational Therapy and Thai Elephant Conservation Center, Lampang Province. It's about 45 minute drive from Chiang Mai Province. This study supported by Chem Communication and Siam Cement Foundation. It's a big company in Thailand. Okay. Right now, they still support us for the student in the program. In this study, we have 4 case study with ASD, and the program we design as an intensive program, as a full day program. It's not like regular program, like children go to my OT clinic just only 45 minutes. But this one, we provide them intensive, a whole day program, okay? And we provide them 4 days a week. I'm sorry. Four days a week for 3 week duration. With this case study, we found that it's improved in balance, sensory processing, the score of sensory processing that we use, the sensory short sensory profile, which is a standardized test, and also the balance is one subtest of the Brunig-Ossorski test to do the score of the balance, and also the adaptive behavior scale. The adaptive behavior we measure by Wieland adaptive behavior scale. It show improvement in these three areas. And also we have many story from the first study. For example, a boy, a 19 years old, who have never been hugged by his father because he have tactile defensiveness. He be able to hug his father after the program. And also another boy, he's very scared when he used the elevator or the lift, something like that. But after the program, he be able to use the elevator or the lift. I recognize he's fearful. You know, the first time that he would like to get on the elephant, I told him that, you know, if you don't want to get on the elephant, it's fine. You can walk along with the elephant. But if you would like to be on the elephant, it's just fine also, because the elephant is just a car for you to be sit on, okay? So that time he decided to ride on the elephant, but he closed his eye all the way. All the way that we do a short distance of walking. But later on, toward 12 session, you know, we do the total is 12 session. Toward the last session, he very happy when he riding the elephant. He sing a song on the elephant while he riding the elephant. And also one boy, when he the first day that he went to the elephant program, he wear the sandal. And with the sandal, when you riding on the elephant, the sandal will be loose and drop down. So he asked his aunt to buy the new pair of shoes, but he didn't know how to communicate with his aunt that he needs some shoes that, you know, can put his heels on, not drop out like the sandal. So he take an ounce to, you know, surround the Tesco Lotus to find the shoes that he can wear, that he could wear, and it will not drop down from the elephant back. Okay, the second study, we did it in 2008 to 2009. It's a further study using an elephant as a therapeutic medium. This one supported by Siam Cement Foundation. This study, we got more participants. From the first one, it's very difficult to recruit the participant, because we didn't know that the elephant will be a good effect or not. Okay, so we recruited four children with ASD from our own clinic, occupational therapy clinic at the Faculty of Associated Medical Science. But in the second study, we be able to recruit more for eight participants with ASD. We still do the intensive care and full day program. But the program changed to be twice a week, only Saturday and Sunday. Do you know why we changed the program to be Saturday and Sunday? Because the program is good for children with mild or moderate autism. So they still have to go to school. If we provide them on the weekday, like in the first program, it's not good for them to be participate in our program. So we move our treatment to be Saturday and Sunday instead, okay? And but we provide longer for 6 week duration. So the participant could go to school and also got the TETP. And with this group, my colleague, she do the focus group, and it's very helpful for the parents to know the other children problem and how to solve the problem. And this come out with a very good result. So we did the third, fourth, it's the third project. Uh-huh. The third project, which is a big, big project. We do in 2009 and 2010. This got supported by Thai National Research Council. We created another two Thai elephant assisted therapy program. One program specialized for reducing stereotype behavior and increasing social skill. But the other one just for reduce dyspraxia or motor planning disorder. We compare the effect of each program in each group of children. And we also compare the effect of different treatment program pattern, because the first program we do provide 4 days a week for 3 weeks, and the second program we provide twice a week for 6 weeks. So in this study, we compare between the long treatment program, 6 week duration, 12 sessions, the same as the other one, shorter for 3 weeks, okay? And when we look at the treatment pattern, 6 week or 3 week, there are no significant difference between these two treatment pattern. But however, when you work on the stereotype behavior or maladaptive behavior, it's quite good for you to provide the treatment with high frequency than the other one. So the shorter will be managed with the behavior better. The sixth study, we study in children with Down syndrome. Compare the effect of treatment between control and experimental group. And this one supported by Faculty of Associated Medical Science and the Golden Triangle Asian Elephant Foundation. Significant difference in visual motor integration, but not in postural control and balance. Postural control was not changed, but balance a little bit different. Slightly increased, but not significant. Probably we have to provide them more than six. This is the, I didn't tell you. It's the eight weeks. It's a 16 session for this group. Okay, now I come to the Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program. So the Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program is a set of activities in the program. We have together around 8-9 activities in the program. We start from the morning. We do the orientation till the last activity will be the relaxation, because we knew that children don't know how to relax themselves, so we teach them how to relax. the activities in the Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program were created by a team of the occupational therapists based on animal assisted therapy model of human occupation and sensory indication frame of reference. The activities in the Thai Elephant Assisted Therapy Program are composed of activities such as buying elephant food, feeding elephants, bathing elephant, playing games with elephant, riding elephant, elephant arts and craft, and relaxation. I'll show you some activity. Okay, for the orientation, the details about elephant, for example, the character of the elephant, the name, the habit, the food, and their ability were provided. Every morning, the schedule of daily activity will be announced in a big group and also told individually. This morning, we have two elephants. The first elephant name, Nam Mui, and the second elephant name, Bai Tong, banana leaf. They are very cute. And children enjoy bathing them. Okay, for buying the elephant food, the material needed is the elephant food vendor. Elephant food, for example, tamarind. Have you know that elephant can eat tamarind? No. Come to see with your own eyes, okay? When the elephant are full, you know, one day I can see the elephant can peel the banana, eat only inside, just like human, you know. And if you provide the elephant food, for example, you give them corns, but they don't want to eat corn now. They put the corn on the ground. You give them sugar cane. They don't want to eat them now. They put them on the ground, okay? So they want to eat banana, then you provide them banana. But do you know what is the main food for the elephant? What is the main food for the elephant? Not the thing that I talk about. The main food of the elephant is the grass, elephant grass, yeah. So we provide, what happened? We provide a purse and real money, okay? Some children with special needs don't know the number, don't know the value of the number, so we provide them with the purse and real number. If they are very low with the concept of number, we provide them like 1 baht, 2 baht, to 5 baht only. But if they are good at the number, probably we provide them 100 or 200 baht in the purse, okay? And to get the purse and the real number, they have to ask for it, okay? So the therapist will ask them to go see their parent, okay? And ask for the money for buy the elephant food, okay? When they get the purse and the, when they get the purse, they will have to open the purse and count how much money they have in the purse before they make a list the elephant food that they want to buy. Okay, and we have the occupational therapist, the shopkeeper, to help them. The method, they will make a list of things need to buy first and then use money to buy them from the shopkeeper. And then they also simulated to see their change as well, whether the change that they receive is correct or not. The next activity is elephant feeding elephant. This activity, we have corn, sugar cane, banana, sunflower seeds, tamarind, watermelon, pineapple, and sometimes cereal and tamarind, like, or sometimes sticky rice also. Yeah. So, elephant can eat candy and ice cream and and chocolate also, you know. It's a like special food, like just like human. They love some special. We asked the children to fetching the food for the elephant, but the suggestion feeding order will be provide sugar cane first. And then the children provide sugar cane, they have to do like this. They should not do, you know, tricky. No, just provide and then the elephant take it. For the sunflower seed, because it's very small, you put, and it come with the plastic bag and have the elastic band tie on the back, on the bag. So the child need to learn how to untie the elastic band first. Okay, so it help with a fine motor coordination, and then pour it to the palm and just give the elephant like that. And the corn is also a good good kind of food to provide the elephant, because we can ask the child to get the shell out first, you know, and then they hold the outside and give to the elephant. You understand me? With the this is the corn. You have to get the outside. Yeah, you have to peel it first. And then you grab the outside, and then you hold it and give to them. So it's also, it provides a lot of sensory information for the child, because many kinds of food provide many texture for sensory information for the brain. Okay, this is feeding the elephant. We also teach the child to touch the like the cheek or the trunk of the elephant. It feels very good, because the under the skin is a lot of fat. It's very thick skin, but it have energy in under the skin. I don't know how to say it. You have to touch it by yourself. Okay, this is bathing elephant. The material we use is a bucket and elephant soap. Elephant soap at the beginning, I think we're going to use the elephant soap like gel, like the elephant, like the soap normally. But no, not the real soap. The elephant soap made from the branch of tree, a special branch of tree, and heat it till it's soft. When you splash the water all over the elephant, then you use this branch of tree we call elephant soap, and you rub it widely, and it will make a bubble, a cream, bubble cream for you. And then after that, the children rinse the bubble with water again. Yeah. And it's good too, because the elephant not only standing, the elephant can lie down for the children to take a bath. While the elephant lie down, we provide them with the banana, the sunflower, so we like hide the elephant to lie down for us. Do you understand me, my point? So in order to the elephant to lie down for a specific period for you until the child can take a bath, take a bath, you provide the food for the elephant. So the elephant so happy to eat while they allow the children to do the spa on the body. We call get on and off the elephant. We use the elephant dummy and also the real elephant. Before the children experience the real elephant, we provide them with the artificial elephant. We have two elephant dummy like this. One is big and another one is small. And The way to get on the elephant actually is have a pattern. For example, the first step, you need to use your right hand to grab the right ear of the elephant. And then you have to raise your right leg up to be on the elephant leg. And then you lean forward. And then you swing your left leg and sit on the elephant. So it's good, very good to help the children who have poor motor planning, don't know how to organize their body. So it's very good activity for them because it's a specific pattern of movement that require them to sit on the elephant. And also we teach them the elephant command. For example, we would like the elephant to go forward. We have to say bye-bye. And if we would like the elephant to stop, we have to say how. Some children say how in Thai is yawning. But for the elephant command, it means stop. Okay. And another command like, okay, turn left, turn right. They have both the oral command and also the physical command. They have to use the left leg, left foot and right foot to skid, to touch a little bit behind the ears of the elephant. For example, if you would like the elephant to turn right, okay, to turn right, you need to use the left foot to touch or stimulate behind the ears of the elephant. So this one is good to help children who have communication problem because it's very structured for them. What to say for certain action. Okay, and come the riding elephant. This is another highlight activities in the elephant program. Most of the kids love to be on top of the elephant because, you know why? Because we are very small, right? When compared with the elephant. When you be able to sit on the elephant, you feel good about yourself. And also when you be able to tell the elephant to go forward or to turn left, turn right, it's like, I feel good about myself because I can do it. I can ask the elephant to do this and do that. And I also pass the fear of being on the top of the neck of the elephant. So the riding will be riding for a short distance. If the child is scared, we just ask the elephant to stand still, okay? And when they're not scared, then we do a short distance. And if they are familiar with the riding, then we do a longer distance. We're riding the elephant uphill and downhill. This is very good for the vestibular system, for the postural control and balance. Okay, this is the some picture of the riding elephant. So some kids are small. When some kids are small, you can ask the elephant to sit down like this. Okay, if they can get on the elephant when they're standing like this, you just the elephant will raise this leg up, and then they do like this. And the leg is this, and then they bring the leg up so you come close to the back of the elephant. So this is the way that normally people get on the elephant. Okay, this one is another activities that I love it because it provides the opportunity for children with special needs. The purpose of this activity is for learning about rules. You know, you stay with others, you need rules. You play with others, you express feeling. Normally, some children of ASD, they have mask face. They don't show any feeling through their face. So it's time that occupational therapists teach them how to express the feeling, how to cheer their friend to become the winner. And also learn how to be the loser, how to work with their friends. We have many games, for example, throwing and catching ball, relay running, bowling, building tower, throwing rings, dragging. This one is lock. L, not collect. L O G, I think. Yeah. This one is a building tower. So they bring the cube, many cube, and then put on the ground, and then build to be a tower higher. So the team that finish first will be the winner. For the game, normally we will let the children to practice first. So they practice, still they get the skill, you know, because there's motor planning, their sensory, their balance is not good. So we provide them the opportunity to practice, to get some skill that require from that game first. And then we play three games after that. So we address on practice before playing. This one is bowling game. So you can see. This one throwing ball to the basket. This one is you know, they have to dig the water, and the elephant will provide them the bucket with water, and then they send the bucket with water pass to the member in the team until they fill in another container, okay, and who get higher, I mean get more water, that team will be the winner. And sometimes we ask the children to work together, like this one. We use the what we call that, the towel, okay, and ask them to children carry the towel, and we put the balls on, and then they have to walk together to bring the ball and pass the ball to the others. In the afternoon, we do the elephant arts and craft. This is some product. So this kind of activity, the benefit is the attention, okay? The attention and also the friendship, how to share the equipment, okay? And also to express their feeling after they finish the activities. Okay, the last activity that I have is the relaxation. This one we provide it because we would like the child know how to relax, so not frustrate and burst out sometime, you know. So this one we provide a relaxing environment in a room with a controlled temperature, and also we control the light. The light is also another factor that help the child to relax. So we turn off the light to get it more dark room. Okay. We use breathing exercise. We ask the child to put the hands on the tummy, and then breathe in deeply and hold. And we count 1, 2, 3. And then we ask them to breathe out slowly and count 1, 2, 3. Okay, we do it 10 times, and then after that we do the progressive muscle relaxation. This one we will ask the child to tense the muscle in some area. For example, from head to toe. Maybe we start from tense your close your mouth tightly. Can you do close your mouth tightly? 1, 2, 3, and then ask them to relax it, and then we count 1, 2, 3. So we do many organs, I mean many parts of the body, and then go from the head to the feet and come back to the head again. We do deep pressure for some severe, okay, and do some joint compression technique. If you like, maybe after I'm speaking down there, I can show you how to do it. Okay, that's all that I have for the program. This is an environment, so it's like dark like this. Okay. I think from the elephant program, is I think it's very good for the mood and emotion. Normally, children who joy will be able to smile, you know, after the program, the whole day. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.